Okay, let's open up this hood. See what we all got going on inside. Got a lot of wire to cut. I really went all out in wiring this thing down. The rules say you're allowed 4 spots to hold the hood down to the car. So there's 2 there and 2 over there. And the rules also say, starting last year, you can use as much chain or 9 wire to hold your bumper to your car. So we just stuck a strand there, one there, and one there. So we have 4 3 wire strands going through, holding this up. So I'm gonna cut all them and we're gonna open up this hood and see what's under here. This side's cut. Okay, the hood's now open. A little bit of a pain, but we got it open. Let's climb up here and see what we got going on. Okay, well, we got a mystery here. Somehow our air filter is completely loose. We had a, let's see if there's a wing nut on there still. Wow, it is. That wing nut and these washers were tightened down on top of our air filter lid and it held this thing down. See how loose it is now. Those washers must have ripped right through the center of our lid holding this down. This must have been a pretty hard hit to rip through that. Wow. I was wondering if they fell off, but nope. Oh well. Still there. Wheel clearance worked out pretty well. You can see the metal we've been under. It's not touching the wheels yet. We did not break any tie rods, no A-arms. They barely even bent. Both the front wheels are still almost completely straight. Which is surprising because we took some big hits to the side. That's good. Our steering column down in there is still fine. We have that double knuckle one. Still have yet to test that out. Whenever your front end bends up, it should allow you to keep steering when it's really high in the air. One of these times we'll get to test it out. All the plug wires are still on. And the spark plug wires are missing down there. Nothing melted off or rubbed against the pipes. Let's see if we still have any power steering fluid or not. Yeah, that's still full of fluid. So power steering still works fine, no leaks there. All the caps are still on the back of our alternator, so it's still giving us a charge. All that's hooked up good, not bad. Our radiator, I don't see any leaks from the inside here. Both of our red straps held. This metal one came loose, but the center metal one still held. No leaks over there. We'll check the fluid level on that. Let's see if it's still pretty full. I'm sure it went a little bit down since the motor was hot and it probably evaporated some. Rubber seals are still good on it. That's good. And there's the water level, if you can see in there. There you go, get some light in it. Still completely full. That is awesome. No leaks at all. The hose is blue. Fan's still good. We'll get to use that for another year. Now that we check that fluid level, let's see how much brake fluid's in here. And if I was to take a guess, I would say there's probably none, or almost completely empty. During the middle of our heat, we lost half our brakes, and during the feature, we lost all of our brakes, so I'm pretty sure it's out of fluid. Okay, got that wire piece holding it down off. Kind of off. Well, maybe they both didn't blow, I'm not sure. That one's definitely empty, completely drained of fluid. It looks like the front canister still has half, so I don't know, maybe that one has a slow leak, or that just all didn't leak out. All I know is we have no brakes. The indicator light that's still in the car, I guess it still had the wires hooked up to it, right there. As soon as the brakes went out, that brake light right there was flashing. Every time I touched the pedal, it would flash on and off, on and off. So it was still working, it knew the brakes weren't working. So that's one fluid we're out of. Pretty sure we don't have any oil leaks. And I know for sure the transmission fluid's pretty much empty because that burned up and drained out. I'm not sure where the leak is at yet. I haven't found a seal that blew. I might take the transmission pan off and see what all fell through the bottom of it. See how chewed up it is. And over here is where our brake lines broke. You can look under and see it. There's a wet spot on the trailer where it's been dripping out of. And that crush box is on the passenger side, was really rusted out already before we ran this derby. If you look way back in there, you can kind of see right there, that's a big rust spot. It starts on the side and goes all the way under, and the whole inside of the crush box is rusted out where it attaches to the frame. But right there is part of our stock brake lines. We just hooked them up and ran them. We didn't have time to put in new ones. So when that crush box started collapsing, it ripped our brake lines up inside of there, and that's where it all drained out at. Just a reason why people should run their own brake lines, I guess, if you really think you need brakes. I didn't have any problems with it. There's our transmission chained to the crossmember. It still held up. Crossmember didn't break. If you look around the transmission, you can see it's all wet. You can see where it's been draining out at. Oh, hey there, Sparky. You coming to visit us? Sniffs the smells in the car. Blue ramps held up good. They didn't bend at all. So, those things are doing great. Our axle. A lot of people were thinking this axle was going to break on this car, since it is the stock axle in an 80s Lincoln, and they're known for breaking. But we took some big hits to the axle and it hasn't broke at all. This wheel might be a little bit bent. I think if we look at the back, you can see it's got a slight curve to it. That one's still straight over there. So overall, this axle held up good. It looks like we got ourselves a visitor coming to check out the car.
You guys still drawing us up on it.